Okay, so companies do have privacy policies that address the various things that we discussed. Well, how well do they do on those privacy policies? We even actually talked about scoring the policy, the EFF quiz we did. But if they have these policies in place, how well do they follow them? Or do they adhere to these policies that they declare they're following and operate according to the policy that you had agreed to? Now, you want to do business with them. You want to have a Facebook account. Facebook said you can only do that if you agree to the privacy policy. You gave consent. Are they going to sort of stay within the boundaries of that policy, or they are not? And there are times when companies actually don't do that. Facebook, the example that we're talking about, actually was not only didn't do it, the U.S. Federal Trade Commission, or FTC, actually had to go after it for violating people's privacy policy in the sense that they were doing things that the users had not given consent to. So what did they do that was bad, which resulted in the FTC action? So either they did something they shouldn't have done, or they didn't do something that was expected by users that they would do. Well, they did a couple of things. They made information users had designated as private, in particular it was friend list, they made it public without user consent. They also made personal information available to applications of friends. So the idea here is, you know, friend, then they can access something, but this was personal information that you had not agreed per the policy you had agreed to, that was made available to these applications. They shared information with advertisers that it had promised not to share with. Remember, so collect, use, and the next thing was share. And, you know, if I should know who they're sharing it with. In this case, they shared it with people when they'd promised or told me that they were not going to share. And, you know, they said certain apps are verified, which were really not verified. So that was misleading, of course. So these are the kind of things that they did, which, you know, caught the attention of the Federal Trade Commission. And the FTC then went after them saying, you know, you're violating your users' privacy. So Facebook didn't, you know, or did things that were inconsistent with the privacy policy they had advertised. So we said the FTC took action, and some of the sanctions examples of that, the consequences of this violation for Facebook, the number of those the FTC actually mandated. One is that they had to have a privacy audit, and that had to be done periodically, biannually, and this is going to be done for the next 20 years. So someone from outside has to come and do a privacy audit. We're not going to take their word for it. Their Facebook is prohibited, well, not to do it, misrepresenting privacy and security settings that are provided to consumers. Okay, if you say something is not public, it should not be public. You shouldn't make it public without the consumer being informed or the user being informed about it and agreeing to it. And they also required Facebook to get consent before sharing any information in a way that exceeds their privacy settings. Okay, so the consent thing is big when it comes to privacy. Okay? If you give consent, then they can do whatever you consented to. But the idea here is that consent, affirmative, express consent. People, some, you know, the default should not be that we can share without checking with them. It should be that they should agree to it expressly before you can share it, if this is in a way that is not revealed by their privacy settings. So these are some examples of the sanctions that the FTC, when they dealt with the Facebook case, they came up with, and that's what was slapped on Facebook.